We begin with the music of Bird, and then I'll tell you a little bit more about this program, but for now, enjoy as we begin at least 420 years ago or so in England.
Thank you.
will be traveling across Europe and across centuries, as the program says. And as we turn our attention next to France, we come to probably the greatest of the French harpsichord composers, François Couperin, with his 27 suites known as ordres for harpsichord. We hear the music of somebody writing for this type of instrument too, which I am very fortunate to play today. Very suave sounds, very rich, very sensuous, very dance-like. These are dances, but also rather solemn. I think these are pieces befitting the times, with movement names like Ténébreuse or Lugubre. They might be a little melodramatic, but perhaps not. They do probe the depths of human emotion in a way. And speaking of tragedies in this world, the composer following Couperin is perhaps not a household name. Bortnianski is a name that has gone down in Slavic music history, and to us, his importance is derived from the fact that he was Ukrainian. This movement is from his only surviving harpsichord sonata and shows a great deal of Italian influence, simple melody, simple accompaniment, very lyrical, very beautiful. It's certainly different. It's not music you'd expect to hear coming from the broader world of Slavic music in general, but it is absolutely exquisite, and I hope it'll inspire you to go look up Ukrainian classical music. It's very much needed in our time. And then the last piece on the first half of the program is by the Estonian composer Rein Rannep. It's a set of variations that explores just about every conceivable sound a harpsichord can make. What's funny to me is that Rannep, even though he was trained very, very highly in the classical, broadly speaking, classical compositional trade, he returned to Estonia, joined a rock band, and is largely known in Estonia for his pop music, even though he's a brilliant composer and jazz improviser, and you'll hear all of that in his pieces. And especially this one. So, we are going to travel very quickly, so be sure to grab some souvenirs on the way.
Thank you.
And now for something completely different.
Thank you.
As we begin the second half of this program, I had the thought that I could have titled this program something to do with improvisation or playing on a whim or something like that, making it up as I go, because harpsichordists will know that's what we do very often as continual players, but besides the point. We have three toccatas and toccata-type pieces on the second half of this program from not quite equidistant from each other, but I'd say fairly well spaced apart. Claudio Merulo writing for the organ and or the harpsichord. Pieces based on the modes using some kind of psalm tone modification. You can imagine a choir singing with perhaps stringed instruments or a cornetto ornamenting around the choir. It's this beautiful piece and fitting for this beautiful church we're in. J.S. Bach, what more can be said about him than has been said so eloquently? But I will say he will surprise you a lot with this toccata because he's showing what he can do. He was a young hotshot before he had 20 kids and was teaching full time. The last piece on the program is another composer who was, like Bortnianski and Ranap, not a household name. He is a French-Lebanese composer. His claim to fame was largely that he won 7 first prizes at the Paris Conservatory after failing to get in the first time. And as an improviser and organist, he is an absolute monster on the organ. This is his only piece that was specifically for harpsichord, dedicated to a harpsichordist, and can also be played on the piano if you want. I've had a chance to chat with him about music and his output over Facebook, and he's a very, very warm guy, very, very funny. The piece is modeled after the French organ suite for virtuosos. It starts very heavy-handed, ends very fast, and there's a lot of color spread throughout. It might be a little hard to follow, so latch on to what you might have heard before in the piece, and the unfolding of it will start to make sense as he draws in the listener to the world of improvisation, French-sounding music, because he succeeded Messiaen in Messiaen's job as an organist, and some Lebanese dance rhythms. But first, we'll start with something a little more tame.
Thank you.
Peace on the program is now upon us. I'd like to take this moment to thank you all for coming and to thank the Western Early Keyboard Association for inviting me out here. This is my first time being in Oregon, and so far I'm having a great time. But I appreciate very much this chance to perform for you all, and to you all on the streaming, thank you for tuning in as well. It has been a joy to perform here.